Good afternoon, everyone. Bhavan's Vidya Mandir Poochatty takes great pleasure in participating for the first time in this, the Poetry in Motion event. First of all, we'd like to thank our organizers for doing such a wonderful job in making us feel at home. Today, we'd like to present before you The Bride by Emi Mahmoud. Weddings are fun events for those who attend. But what about the bride? We may be in the 21st century, but arranged marriages, mail order brides, and big fat weddings are still the norm in many parts of the world. Our presentation attempts to highlight the helplessness of the bride, a judgmental society who is ultimately responsible for the streaks of violence that mar the beauty of the bride. However, it is an attempt to create awareness so that we may stop such violence to our tender brides. The poet is Emi Mahmoud, all of 16 years old, winner of the World Poetry Slam 2015, currently a senior at Yale University. She is a Leno Annenberg Scholar and Global Health Fellow. Her area of study is anthropology and molecular biology at Yale. She is involved in the Yale Refugee Project, teaches spoken word poetry in various communities in order to equip the youth with the power of voice. Her parents are refugees from Sudan, and many of the themes in her poems reflect on life as she has seen it and heard narrated by her family. She is truly a powerful voice for the underprivileged. We present to you The Bride by Emi Mahmoud.
Twelve hours ago, then he left the airport and they already started dressing her.
the fate of many a bride all over the world. Why can we not make a change? And bring back radiant, beautiful, smiling brides. Thank you.
No, never.
Okay, we'll keep a tag on that. Okay, number one, see you later.
Vaishnavi
happens to be my niece, sir. So I can keep an eye on her, definitely. Okay. Anyway, that is a beautiful, beautiful message that Bhavan has done. And I'm also happy that your inaugural entry into poetry in motion has been such a stupendous success, sir. Did you enjoy yourselves? Yes, sir. But what about the boys in your school? Have they come today here? Will the Bhartiya Bhavan boys please stand up? Now, do you agree with what your girls have presented? What? Yes or no? Oh, then I know they are going to win. Your yes proves that they are going to win. Do you agree? Was it a beautiful program? Oh, look at that.
Just reeling from the aftermath of the CBSE State Sahodaya in which we participated. So I must applaud this group of children for their dedication because we started Monday evening. It is out of 2 days of their practice and their dedication. The PhD actually they've already earned it. They've shown passion, they've worked very hard and they've got a start.
Every year. Okay, this is the first time, it will not be the last time. Because there are... No, tomorrow is the Malayalam one. And all good things, yes sir. Of course, these two mentors will not be there because their Malayalam is not fluent enough. Tomorrow, we will be having the Malayalam section of this. So, again, all of you are welcome that this year it is going to be such a magnificent... Every year has been doing well. And I'm glad that the public library and the round table, they are with us. Sunil, have you anything to say? Yeah.
Some 4 or 5 or 6 years back, there was a front page picture in the national newspaper. 5 girls, a quarter of Indian newspaper, and I read the news item. There were 9 standard students in another time. Jaipur. One of the girls' marriage was fixed, and the other 4 girls decided the marriage will never, they will not allow the marriage to take place. First, they went to the parents of this girl whose marriage was fixed and begged him not to marry. She is not of age. They did not agree. On the day of the marriage, all these 4 girls went to the father and created a scene. Of course, priorly informing the police in prayer. And they created a scene and the marriage did not take place. These 4 girls saved at least one of their friends from the marriage.
Thank you. I'd
like to thank Nalini ma'am to invite us to be a part of such a lovely program. We in the round table, we do a lot of good things. We help a lot of underprivileged children get into the mainstream and try and, you know, build infrastructure for their education. But when we approached ma'am, we just approached ma'am with another idea, and she introduced us to this poetry in motion. I can't even express my gratitude to her, because for me and Ravi, it's been a mind-boggling experience to see young children doing such a fantabulous job, and they expressing each and every emotion, each and every word on stage. It's fabulous, ma'am. Thank you for allowing us to be a part of such a wonderful program. I'm sure we will be associated with you for more such things. Thank you.
I'll let you proceed, Pooja. You know, when they came, they wanted the normal thing. We want elocution, debate, quiz, debate, elocution, debate. So I said, my dear boy, there are much more into it. It's not that, of course, all that is important. But everybody is only talking about apples and apples and apples. So that's a time when he came along and I thought, ah ha ha, I'll catch hold of the scapegoat. Why? I wanted Dugda, money for the lunch. All right? Now today I can say, oh, good lunch. I don't have to look at our treasurer and say, oh, have you got enough? Do we have to count all the pennies? We don't have to count the pennies. So it is mutual, my boy. Thank you for coming at the right time and helping us. The same way public library, they're always poverty students. Always poor libraries, poverty. They got books and books and books. They got large hearts. And they want to do so much for us. And I know that they want to do it. But what to do? This is a very, very difficult thing. So thank you. But they did all the homework, all the phone calls, all, you know, the messages that had to be sent. But a particular thing, thank you to Uni Krishna. Okay? So once again, I think we've got more thanks. Thank you.